new series starts Monday at 10:35. Well, a show-stopping performance now on BBC One, running a little late. It's time to solve that problem.
Helena versus Connie. Two girls with one dream. In the next half an hour, the nation will decide who will become Maria Von Trapp and win the biggest job in show business. Not even the Lord can save them now. Tonight, it's down to you. Climax as the two girls go head to head in a bid to become Maria. The lines are still open and every vote counts. Here, singing their favourite song from the series to remind you just how great they are, it's Helena and Connie!
Yeah. Yeah. And I want you to know my mind. I think I'll tell you.
Brilliant. All right. Early this evening, we saw Siobhan crash out of the final and take third place. Losing out to Helena and Connie was a bitter pill to swallow. Here's how she took the news. The girl in third place, and sadly, out of the competition, is Siobhan.
Finals, chucked out, gutted. It was a long journey, it was hard, and it's just a bit annoying that it's had to end so soon. So long, farewell, happy to say goodbye. One day, I will be on a West End stage because that is my new goal.
You are a star.
I really hope I can win it. I really hope that the viewers at home have seen enough of me in the past 6 weeks to believe in me, and I believe they do.
It's just phenomenal. There's no words to describe how amazing this is.
I think the door's just closed, but I reckon there's probably a window opening.
Thank you, Andrew. Thank you for all your help.
So you weren't even in the competition, and now you've come third in our final. But now, the battle for the Wimple is between Helena and Connie, and it's you that has the final say on who becomes Maria, making it the first time that the British public will cast a major West End role. Here to help you make your mammoth decision is the panel. Please welcome back, for the last time, West End leading man John Barrowman. Vocal coach Zoe Tyler. Theatre producer David Ian. And of course, the phantom genius who's had his saving power taken away, Andrew Lloyd Webber. It was only a matter of time. All right. Andrew, the power and the mirror have been taken away from you. Helena and Connie, the nation are going to cast one of them as Maria. How are you feeling right now?
Well, since my power's completely taken away from me now, two superb performances tonight, which is I think, a tribute to how this programme has worked with the whole idea of Maria's School, because we didn't know that we would find these two artists come through at the beginning. And Helena, at the end of the day, came from really, nowhere. I'm so proud to be involved with this programme, and so the panel, because this has proved something that I think people didn't feel could happen at this sort of show, and I think it's proved that it's really valuable to bring these young artists and give them this amount of time on television.
All right. Well, whether he likes it or not, the Lord has given away all his power. The text lines have now closed, but if you want your favourite to win, vote. I can tell you, it's very, very close between our final two. So every single vote will count. Here's a reminder of Helena and Connie's performances with the numbers you need to dial.
Oh, my God, that was fantastic!
You've won the public over, you've won me over. Well, you could win this tonight.
Do you know what? I'm so happy that they just like me, that, whatever happens now is just a bonus.
So, a needle-pulling thread.
I saved you four times, and I knew somewhere in my bones that I was right.
What a transformation we've seen in you. Unbelievable over these weeks. You've saved your best for last.
So, a dear, a female dear.
She sings, she dances, she acts. You're fabulous. You definitely are the leading lady. You should be Maria. You need to be on the Palladium stage. That's what I think.
Show tonight. You nailed it. You were fantastic.
Amazing performances from both of you. Great comments. And I can tell you, the public are going crazy. The phone lines are mad. We've had over 1.5 million votes tonight.
Wow. Wow.
Which is a testament to how good both of you are. Now, you said there that basically being here in the final two is a bonus. Do you really feel like that? Or, I mean, the winning, in the end, it is a competition. Yeah. You must want to win.
The winning, yeah, absolutely. I'd love to win and it will be amazing. But do you know what? Being here is amazing. And there are so many cherries on the top of a cake. They keep piling up. And that would be the very last one. But it's just the whole thing. I couldn't be happier.
Oh, and Connie, I mean, you made Andrew punch the air. Did you see that?
Yes,
punch the air. There's a diva lurking in that man, there is. And, do you hope that those nice comments are going to translate into votes, or do you think the public will respond to the underdog?
Well, of course, I want them to have their perfect Maria. I hope I'm that, and I hope I've shown my consistency and my reliability, my versatility in everything that I've done. So I hope that they enjoy my performance because I enjoy entertaining them.
And walking away from this, what do you think sort of the biggest lesson you've learnt maybe about yourself has been?
When I was in telesales, I lost faith in myself and faith in me on stage, and I didn't really think I'd get the opportunity to do anything like this. So this has been the best thing ever to happen. So I lost faith in myself. So self-belief is what I learnt. And thank you, Andrew, for giving me this opportunity. And thanks to everyone at home.
Well, congratulations to both of you. Fingers crossed for both of you. You've both done so, so well. Now, it's not just Maria Land that is in a state of frenzy about who wins the biggest role in showbiz. It's become a major talking point back in the real world.
I would very much like to see Connie in a pair of lederhosen.
Go, Connie!
She's a telesales girl, so at the end of the day, if she forgets a line, she can always go, "Hi, can I help you with your credit card?"
She looks like a Maria and she sings lovely.
I'd like Connie to win because I think she's got the best voice.
Helen, I'm backing you all the way.
You can do it this week. You can go one step further and you can be Maria.
When she came from nowhere, she has had the biggest mountain to climb.
I think Helena will be the next Maria.
She deserves to win.
She's worked so hard. Exactly.
Every time we've seen her, she's really going for it.
Helena, you've made it so far against all the odds, and I'll definitely be rooting for you tonight.
A lot of support there. Helena in particular must be delighted that fishmongers and nuns who appear to be in pubs are supporting her. By the way, but that's who the public want, but who do you want? OK, here are the numbers again. Helena to win, call 09011213302. Or if Connie is your Maria, call 09011213303. Now, Andrew, you mix in different circles than the rest of us. So, what's the word in your posh street?
Well, I tried to get hold of David Cameron this afternoon, and I got a call back within 10 minutes to say he was too busy to talk to me and had been travelling. So I spoke to Tony Blair's office.
Are you making this up?
No,
did you really call
no,
Tony Blair's
I called
office?
Them this afternoon, and I called his office, and they said that Tony was too busy at the moment over the weekend, and they didn't want to disturb him.
Probably packing.
So I called the Lib. So I called the Lib Dems and they said they were at a party conference, and I called the Pope and he was in a holy see. So it didn't go terribly well. You see, my address book isn't as good. There is one name I'm not allowed to mention, of course.
God?
But no.
he has a hotline.
No, he's something you find on top of a monk.
What,
it's a cowl.
Head?
No, it's a cowl.
Oh.
Oh. Ooh, he was told not to. I was told by not to mention that.
But he has it. So he's been watching?
Yes. Oh, yes.
Well, throughout our series, Andrew has set the girls a multitude of difficult challenges. They've worked with children, tackled assault courses, and even had to kiss John Barryman. They'll do anything to get the role. With that in mind, we set our potential Marias their ultimate mission.
What we've got to come away from this programme with is the right girl. This is about a girl who's got to hold 2,400 people every night.
Ooh. The hills are alive.
You put real expression into the song itself, and that was really a good performance.
The
You were playing the room a bit, which was good. Yeah, I'm very pleased with you today.
No passion,
no real excitement there.
And I almost wanted to sort of throw a whole heap of mud at her.
We haven't seen them act, and this they have to do, because the whole show rides on this.
Brigitte could tell you about him. Brigitte could tell you a lot if you take the time to get to know her.
You see, the thing is that you can act, you can do it.
Because she notices things, and she'll always tell the truth.
I was very, very impressed by that.
I haven't finished yet.
It was a very, very nice little performance. She came forward far more than I ever wildly expected.
To be a leading lady, you must have stamina.
If somebody's not fit, it means they miss shows. And missed shows and leading ladies mean one thing to me, refunding tickets.
141. Well done.
Wow, it's hard.
The hardest thing I've ever done.
Okay. No, you weren't. That was awesome.
We could have done so much better.
That's fine.
I think Connie may need to work on her fitness.
I want to do it again.
This is extremely important. To be upstaged by children is an actor's nightmare.
She's truly scrumptious.
This wonderful, gorgeous sort of total innocence.
It's so delicious.
What a voice she's got, a really lovely voice. But she slightly screws her face up, and therefore you don't quite get the joy that she's singing.
Because I love you, Jamie.
She's a wonderful actress.
I do.
And of course, Maria must be able to seduce the captain.
The one thing that people have the problem with, they always think, oh, I can't look into another girl or another guy's face. Rubbish. It's theater, you gotta get over all those qualms.
If I never felt this love, you're beautiful. I will love you.
I could feel myself just melting. Watching the other girls kiss him, I felt quite jealous. I just snogged John Barrowman and really went for it.
Andrew's final test is the ultimate Maria mission.
We're going to head to the hills. Be uninhibited, just be Maria now, and just enjoy yourself, use this fantastic countryside.
The hills are alive with the sound of music, with songs they have sung for a thousand years.
You know, that's goosebump time. I mean, just hearing that song live in this atmosphere, it's amazing. The public have got to realise that the girl has got to deliver that big performance 6 shows a week. And it's very, very important that it's the right girl that's chosen.
Andrew, that is an extraordinary thing for these girls to have done, for them to have actually performed in the hills.
There was something even more extraordinary, because I actually said to our crew, I said, this is pointless, because it was a hot day, and I said, I can't judge the singing. And they started, I went through the motions, and suddenly, from the hills, came an echo. Did it not, girls? And it was the biggest goosebump moment I can remember in my career, because suddenly, the whole meaning of the lyrics came to me. I mean, the hills are alive with the sound of music. And they were, and the mountains were 2 miles away. And my secretary was on a mobile phone, because she'd been told to get out of the way. And she heard it, you know, just 800 yards away. And it was just electric.
And what must they do to impress us in theatreland?
Well, they won't quite have that echo, will they? But what they have to do is what we've said all the way along, girls, and you know that. It's the utter professionalism that we need, the utter understanding of this extraordinary story of this young girl who took this family and then, in the end, having married the captain, had the courage to take them away from that extraordinary, idyllic homeland.
All right. Well, over 2 million people have now voted. Ooh. And, yeah. But keep voting, because now the sound of music. This is the ultimate song for our girls to master. It's the song that our winning Maria will open the musical with. Now, we've seen Helena and Connie sing it on top of an Austrian mountain, but can they perform it in front of an audience?
Well, we're about to find out. This is the real test. Here, performing for your votes, with the sound of music, please welcome Helena and Connie! Connie and Helena's biggest fans. Jenny is Helena's mom, and Jan, you're Connie's mom, and over here is Nana Dot. Yes. Now, there you are. You've seen Helena in the sing-offs. Here she is. She nearly is Maria. How do you feel?
Very tense. I mean, she's my little girl. She would be auditioning for the children, but I can't believe she's auditioning for Maria, and I just think she's absolutely wonderful and so deserving.
And she's been in the bottom two so often, you poor thing. That must be horrible to watch.
It was horrible to watch, but I'm so glad that she's got this far, because the audience would never have seen what she can do, and I think she can still do a lot more.
And talking to Helena, you were one of those mothers, you kind of brought her to the acting classes, the dancing classes, the singing classes. Bit of a bit pushy mom, really.
No. She gave up dancing once and regretted that, but...
Is that because you hate her?
No. But they all said she could sing, and I thought, well, hang on a minute, I don't think she can. But when she started entering festivals and won, I thought, oh, perhaps she is quite good, you know. So that went from there. So
well,
I'm delighted.
You must be so pleased you pushed her now.
Oh, wow, yeah, she's a superstar. She does it all on her own now, though. She just says, back off, Mum, I can do it on my own.
And clearly she can. Clearly she can. Now, Connie was telling us earlier, Nana Dot, that you taught her the Sound of Music songs when she was a little.
Yes. When she was about five, I used to take her to school and we used to improvise little songs, you know, about the postman and all things like that. And then it was fun.
Oh, this must be amazing for you to be here and see.
Oh, I know. She's fantastic, isn't she?
She really is. They both are. They're terrific.
Yeah.
And now, and Jan, apart from the obvious answer that she's your daughter, why should the public pick up the phone and make her Maria?
Well, I think from a very early age, Connie will agree, all she really wants to do is entertain.
Yes.
In whatever role, but I know, darling, this is your absolute role, but... She is an entertainer, and that's all she loves to do, and I think she'll spend her life doing it.
All right, well, fingers crossed for both of them. They're both a hair's breadth away from getting that dream role.
Yes.
Good luck. Hope the nerves hold out. All right, thanks. OK, well, shortly we will find out which Other Girls is going to win. There's still time left to vote for your favourite before we close the lines. Now, it doesn't take a genius to work out that there are two girls left in the running, but eight girls aren't. Here, performing Edelweiss, please welcome back our former Marias, Laura, Belinda, Melise, Simona, Leanne, Abby, Aoife and Siobhan. Are now officially closed. Before we reveal the name of the winner, let's get the panel to nail their colours to the mast, and I'm going to ask them, Helena or Connie, who should become Maria? John.
I love both of them, but going on what I've said from day one, for consistency and performance, I have to go with Connie.
Okay. Zoe.
I can't bear this. For me, going on vocal progression for the last couple of weeks, I have to say Helena.
And David.
I've auditioned over 6,000 people, and I know that the most all-round talented person I saw was Connie.
OK, that's what the panel think. Let's now ask the man whose reputation and musical is on the line. Andrew, who do you want to be Maria?
Well, Helena sang wonderfully tonight in The Sound of Music. Connie, a little tired vocally, because I think she did Shout and did The Lonely Goat, her two huge numbers. The thing about Connie is that she is a wonderful actress, and through her eyes and everything, you see what she's intending. Because she's such a fantastic actress, and I know she will be able to sing it, my vote's Connie.
That's what Andrew wants, but is his vision ultimately the same as yours? We're about to find out. I have the results. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back two girls, one of whom is on the brink of West End stardom. It's Miracle Maria Helena. All All your votes have been counted and verified. The moment of truth has finally arrived. Helena and Connie, you've both worked so hard to get to this point in the final. It's been an epic journey. The nation has now decided who will become Maria von Trapp. For one of you, life is about to change forever. The girl the public have cast to be Maria von Trapp is... Connie! Going to be singing them in the West End. I'm so pleased for you.
Thank you. Thank you. Just thank you to everybody who's voted. Thank you very much. I look forward to every performance that I give you, and every night will be an opening night. Thank you for making my dreams come true.
A bridesmaid no more. Well, it may be the end of the show, but it's just the beginning for you, Connie. So, if you would do one more thing and think for us one last time. You want to go propose yourself? Well done, darling. Thanks to the band, the panel, the Lord, and ultimately, thanks to you at home, we now have our winner. Here is an exclusive performance of The Sound of Music. It's the Maria you have chosen. Here she is, Connie!
Like a brook as it trips and falls over stones on its way to sing through the night like a lark who is learning to play. I want to play when my heart is lonely. I know I will do what I